It's pretty clear that over the last few years, Garmin with their LiveSight and Hummingbird with their 360 imaging sonar have been the leaders in the fishing electronics category. They also both have frequency ranges on side imaging in the megahertz. They both offer chirp frequencies in traditional sonar view and down and side imaging views. These are all things that Lowrance units can't do in 2020. So why would you still buy a Lowrance unit today? Hi, I'm Lauren, and welcome to this video where I'm going to show you three exclusive reasons why you should still consider Lowrance today. While they've been left behind in a lot of ways, Lowrance is still innovating and have some really cool and exclusive features that nobody else does. The first feature available on Lowrance units that I want to look at is Structure Map. This first came out several years ago, I believe on the HDS Gen 2 Touch units as a live overlay on your map that could be saved. Well, they have it a step further now where you can record your sonar logs and go back and save those as map overlays to provide high detail side imaging on your chart page. This is a structure map from an old sonar log that I have converted into the map. One of the settings on structure map you can adjust is the transparency to see the Navionics chart come through. As the transparency is increased, we can see more of the Navionics chart, but it's harder to see the detail on the structure map. If you look at this example with structure map overlay, we can see a large weed bed forming a point. As we increase the transparency, you can see how we have an underwater point from the contour lines in the Navionics chart that the weed bed is growing on. In addition to that, we also have several large isolated boulders just off the weed edge. Now, imagine being able to position your boat perfectly on this structure to hit that weed point or boulders. You'll also have all your waypoints show up on the structure map as well because it's overlaid on your GPS screen. The key with structure map though is to try and plan your maps. If you find a good spot you'd like a map of, be sure to map it strategically, basically just doing a grid over the structure you want the detail of. This will give you the best detail and accuracy of the structure map. Structure map is one way to get a detail level similar to that of Hummingbird 360 imaging, but just not in real time. The benefit to structure map though is it's overlaid on the Navionics chart. This really helps you understand the cover on the structure. The next Lowrance exclusive feature we're going to look at is Fish Reveal. This combines the fish finding abilities of traditional sonar and the high detail structure views of down imaging into one screen. Many thought down imaging would replace traditional sonar when it came out, but there were too many shortfalls with it. Lowrance took the best qualities of each and put them together. You get the high detail bottom structure views of down imaging and the fish finding abilities of traditional sonar. This information overlaid together saves you a full screen panel, allowing for more information to be displayed on split screens. This is especially helpful if you have a smaller screen unit like a 7 or 9 inch screen. If you want to learn more about Fish Reveal, be sure to click this card to check out my full Fish Reveal video or check the link in the description. This next feature on Lowrance is an awesome one. It's their wireless networking available on the Elite TI 2 units. It's surprising that no one else has come up with this yet. Sure, we can network units with cables, but the fact that all units have wireless technology in them now, this only makes sense. The average fisherman is only networking units for the purpose of sharing waypoints. So doing that wirelessly eliminates the problems with running cables, figuring out NMEA 2000 networks, and just saves a lot of time during the install. Lowrance has made pairing the units extremely easy as well. With both units powered up, you'll go into the gear icon on the top left of the home screen. From there, you select System, then scroll to Wireless, then the top option, Connect to another Elite TI unit, will begin the pairing process. The first unit you pair will be the base unit, so we'll select that top option. On the second unit, we go back to the same menu, but here we select the second option because we've already chosen our base unit. This unit will now locate your base unit, as shown here, Elite 7 TI 2 A859, and we tap that to pair. Once paired, both units will return to the wireless menu. We can now take a look at some of the features of this wireless networking. The first and most common reason you'll network units is to share waypoints, as I said. We can be fishing at the bow and save a waypoint, it'll automatically save on the console unit, and the opposite is also true. If we want to delete a waypoint, we can highlight it on either unit and delete it. It then deletes from both units. The other thing the wireless sharing allows us to do is share a transducer. We can select the console Elite 9 TI2 as our sonar source on the bow unit if we like, or vice versa. The impressive thing about this is how quick all this works and how reliable it is. If you didn't know better, you'd think there was a cable between the units. Best of all, these features are available on the mid-level Elite TI2 units, so that means you don't have to spend an arm and a leg to get them. The 7-inch model is $769, the 9-inch model is $969 and the 12-inch model is $1769. Those are some of the lowest prices for features like these. A basic LiveScope system will run you $2150 and a Mega 360 system $2400. So if you don't think you'll ever need those features, the Elite TI units offer a lot of features that nobody else can do for a very affordable price. So those are three things that only a Lowrance unit can do. There's one other thing worth noting, and it's a small one but important, and it's their Solar Max displays. No unit on the market is as good as Lowrance in direct sunlight. If you have an Elite TI or TI2 unit, you're gonna wanna take a look at this playlist I have, as it's full of videos on how to set up the units. I give away my best settings for Lowrance units that make it so easy to find fish and help make it even easier to use these units. Please check out those videos and be sure to subscribe to my channel. Anything else you guys know that only a Lowrance unit can do, let me know in the comments below. Also, I want to know, what would you do? Would you guys save the money and buy an Elite TI unit for these features, or would you rather save up and get those high-end features that LiveScope or Mega 360 offers? Take a look at these other videos to help you decide. And be sure to subscribe to my channel.